education. I myself a chartered accountant and a US CPA. And as you know, the today's session is more about knowing about the CPA process, because I've noted down a lot of the questions which people have already kept into Instagram. I have seen a few of the questions on Insta. I'll be taking up each and every question. Before that, I just want to introduce the panelists who are there in today's session. We have Anuya, we have Sonam from my team, and Zaki. And any of the questions relating to evaluation, the licensing, and the CP exam process and all, I would request everyone to put up straight away on the chat window, so that as and when I'm taking the session, my team can keep answering those questions also. Previously, in some of the sessions, I wasn't able to answer many of the questions which were kept in the Q&A window because of the time limitation and me doing it parallelly and answering the questions. So today I have a separate evaluation team who can keep answering those questions, because people who want to straight away ask on the eligibility front and any other questions, they can just put it in the Q&A window and my team will pick it up and keep answering that parallelly as we go ahead with the session. And great news, I mean, the CP exam is happening in India, and I think that is a fantastic news which came in last year, and it started as June and December 1st, right? So June, and then it June, September, then it went to December, and then we had a session with AICP and NASBA where it was like, okay, now let us make this as a permanent. And I'm so glad in that session also we had around 950 people participating, and that was the only time when AICP and NASBA have done a session with one of the private institute, and we were glad that we had that session where AICP and NASBA itself came forward and said that the CP exam is permanent in India. That means it's a continuous testing. Every month the exam will be conducted. And I'm not sure if everyone is able to see the screen, please let me know. So there's a separate video on YouTube where we did that. I hope the participants are able to see. Just let me know if anyone is not able to see the screen here. Yes, guys, are you able to see the screen, the video which I'm sharing? So this was one of the very, very important sessions which we did with AICP and NASBA. And this is there in the YouTube. You can just type in AICP and NASBA and Samandar Education, where we called people from AICP, we called people from NASBA and addressed them about the CP exam permanency. Because a lot of the times institutes keep telling that exam permanent and all, but they wanted to listen from the body which conducts the examination. And in this session, we had so many things about the CP exam changes, about the licensing. We had seven panelists from NASBA, from AICP coming up and talking about the CP exam, the structure. I would request after my session, mandatorily, please attend this. Please do go through this video on YouTube, AICP and NASBA at Samandar Education, CPA course, how to become US CPA. So we have kept into all those things in this particular video. So please do go through after the session and see how the CP exam has been permanent. It's just not Sripal Jain talking about it. It's about AICP and NASBA coming straight away to Samandar and talking about these particular things. That's why the trust becomes more important factor when you join any institute. And that's important that you hear from that organization itself, right? Yeah. Anyways, so next, coming back to our CPA piece, right? So as you know, the exam in India is permanent, and which is a fantastic news, and that will help me to structure the examination properly for each and everyone who's attending the CPA exam today, right? Today's session will start about what is CPA and why we need to do CPA, right? And since the exam is in India, it's an online exam, multiple choice question based, how do you structure the examination? And these are all some important questions which I'll go through. And that's where we'll take it up. Now, CPA, when we talk about, right? So like we have in India, the chartered accountants, the US chartered accountants are known as certified public accountants, which is CPA. Right. And many of the times people have confusion about the licensing, about the evaluation, about the eligibility issues, which we'll be discussing in detail. And if I'm a US CMA, if I'm an ACCA, if I want to go to Canada and all these sort of things, the Indian recognition and the global recognition becomes very, very important. But before that, let's quickly ask, why do you want to do CPA? Just not because the exam is in India, so we will do CPA, or exam is every month conducted now in India, so let us do the CPA exam, or CPA exam is computerized, so let's do CPA. But I want to ask everyone who's attending today's session, because this is a very, very important question, right? Why do you want to do this exam? Because as you know, the CPA exam is not so, I mean, less costly, right? It's a costly exam. There's a lot of investment involved. It's almost equal to 3,20,000 to 3,30,000. So it's not an easy investment considering the pandemic around the corner. And the seriousness about this qualification is so very important. It's just not about enrolling and getting it, but it's important to know why you want to do this course. So let me take this up. Yes, attendees, why do you want to do it? Any 5-6 questions? Why do you want to do CPA? Sahil says global level exposure in accounting. Okay, next. I think you meant to say exposure. So I guess there's a spell check. That's fine. Yes, next. As it will open more growth, need a professional degree to scale up. I'm stuck at CA final group 2 to get a global exposure. Want to work in US, provide a global recognition, global opportunities. CPA is the highest accounting degree. Work with overseas client of US to boost my professional career. Addition to degree, better opportunities, make a kickstart at global level. Want to work overseas. Good, good, great. Great chances of promotion. One person is writing about the promotion to expand knowledge. Globally recognized accountancy to work with Big Four and get the exposure. Professional growth, less time taking with a great opportunity. Okay, I think I got much of the questions, but there are some misconceptions in the question where people are writing about to work abroad. Let me clarify this straight away. Okay, with CPA degree, you can't get a job in US straight away. Okay, to get a job in US, I mean, to go to US or to go to Canada, you need a valid visa. Right. So there is a lot of criteria of visa experience and all going by other institutes because they really want to sell the course. So they might tell you that you'll get a job in US, you'll get a job in Canada, which is actually not correct when you see the things here. Right. Because there's a lot of things in between that when you go and see that. Right. So once you pass the exam, you need to write your IELTS exam if you want to move to Canada. Right. And if you want to move to Canada, if you want to move to US, you'll need to work in some company in India and they need to sponsor for your visa and then you move to US. That's an ideal route. Right. Or if you want to just go and do a master's in US, start with an visa, study visa. On that study visa, you have an OPT, you can work in US. I mean, that's only on an internship. Right. So that is what is very important. So directly going with CPA and you'll get a job in US, it doesn't happen like that because there are visa, there is experience requirement, both from Canada perspective and from US perspective. So what is the best bet, sir, then? So once you do a CPA, you will work in India. That is very, very important because there are a lot of US companies coming in India and they are hiring. As you might have seen our latest YouTube videos where we tied up with BDO, we tied up with World Bank. We tied up with EY GDS. I think the announcement will come next week. We tied up with, so we are the exclusive training partners in EY today and are also the placement partners. So when people ask me, sir, what are these tie-ups for? These tie-ups, guys, are for not only training their own employees, like Infosys, we have tied up, right? But we have convinced the management of Infosys, of BDO, of EY, of World Bank to hire the CPAs also in India. And that's where that's a very, very significant tie-up because it gives an opportunity for us to place the students in various companies. And not only this, we have tied up with Invesco, tied up with Deloitte. So such big companies and all with our connections, it makes things very easier for us to place the students. As and when we go ahead the session, I'll show you how we bring those speakers, how we are well connected with the partners. Some of the CPA, some of the partners at Big Four, I do the licensing, right? So that's the respect we have among the Big Fours, among the other companies. It's just that I'm taking that respect and placing our retail students also in those companies through those tie-ups. That is what is known as tie-up. And people keep asking me, what is this corporate tie-up with Simandar I've tied up with? Right. And that's very, very important if you see the broader picture, because after the qualification, I want to know whether I get a job in India or not. And that's why this tie-ups are very important with EY, Deloitte, BDO. And as you know, guys, there are 4 popular audit firms in the world. They are known as Big Fours, which is Deloitte, Ernst & Young, KPMG, PricewaterhouseCoopers. So these companies are hiring CPAs like anything because the global delivery services is expanding in India. In BDO also, BDO is a top 5th global audit company today. And we tied up with BDO also after this EY and Deloitte. And BDO also is opening up their offshore locations in India. And they're trying to expand and hire more 5,000, 6,000 people. And they're expanding their audit services in India. And that's what becomes very, very important for the students to understand that you have a tremendous job opportunities after passing CPA in India. and talking about India location, because a lot of them, they think that, hey, this is a US qualification. Why will you get job in India? But let me tell you that why are US companies working in India then, right? Because they want all their, so what you're seeing is all their finance, their global share services, they are getting outsourced to India. And they get Indian people at a lower cost, right? When you see, if I want to hire a US person, I need to hire at a higher cost. But in India, it's a lower cost. And that's why the margins increases. And it makes sense to hire Indian people here. And that's where they see that if they have a right skill set or not. And that's why it's important that, okay, if he's a CPA, he understands US GAAP, he understands IFRS, right? He understands how the balance sheet is prepared under US GAAP, how the audit is done. So that's why it becomes a very good choice among the recruiters. Okay, let's hire the CPAs and get them into the board, right? And that is very important. Apart from that, I think there are a lot of other things also which they see in a CPA qualification, especially from the industry's perspective. Like, we place people at Standard Chartered, JP Morgan. You might see the placements which are happening up. They're not happening in small companies. Okay, so we have placed them at Amazon. If you have seen Akshay there, he have just completed 3 sections, not even 4 sections. He got 98, 96, 97 in CP. We placed him in Amazon. So that's why you see a lot of placements also happening up after CPA. And that is the first topic which I wanted to take up in today's session, is there a job opportunity after CPA? 110%, that's right. Both for experienced people, if you're a chartered accountant and if you want to do CPA, you actually open up all the opportunities in India today, right? With various companies. See, everyone is doing, CA, and most of them passes also. So what is that different you have apart from CA? And that's what the recruiters are seeing. And that's where the double qualification becomes important. If you're just a CA, it doesn't make sense, right? If you are actually stuck, in CA final, so CPA is a good degree because it's a lesser time qualification. It doesn't take much time like CA. So that's where it becomes very easy. Same for BCom, MBA guys. It's better to invest in CPA with 3 lakhs rather than investing in an MBA with 20, 25 lakhs. And then also you don't know whether you will be placed or not. But here you are pretty sure that the hiring is more, the placements are more, the return on investment is good. So that's why it is a very, very important point which you see in CPA qualification. And that's when the qualification is getting tremendous recognition. Sir, why didn't it get that recognition last year or before that? Please understand that CPA exams were never used to be conducted in India. Now that the exams are being conducted in India, you're seeing that the popularity of the course have gone up. Else previously people used to do ACCA. But let me ask you guys, how many UK companies are in India and how many US companies are in India? So let's try to debate on that. And you tell me guys, how many US companies you have in India? I mean, can you name some US companies here other than Big Four? Everyone on the analyst, on the attendees mode, Walmart. Okay, next. Yes, how many US companies we find in India today? Walmart, Bank of America, BofA. Okay, next, Amazon, Procter & Gamble, JP Morgan, Apple, right? Apple have opened their manufacturing location in Chennai, Credit Suisse, right? GE, General Electric, Morgan Stanley, Goldman Sachs, Tesla have opened up in Bangalore, American Express, Coca-Cola, Microsoft, right? Citigroup, Facebook, right? CSC, Starbucks. But if you see guys, Google and Microsoft, just to clarify, Google, Microsoft and Facebook, they have outsourced their entire finance to Accenture. So Accenture manages their finance division. And that's why you see a lot of placements which I've done at Accenture also. If you'd have noticed, if you'd have followed Samandar closely, right? A lot of the 2-3 placements which we have done, like Richa, some of the few people, I placed them at Accenture because Accenture is kind of expanding like anything. Even if you'd have seen, they have acquired AIG. American Insurance Group, their entire finance division shared services have been transferred to Accenture because Accenture is doing. So don't think, arey, mere ko Facebook mein job mil raha. It's not like that, because you will be on the payroll of Accenture itself because they have outsourced the entire finance team. So I don't want to kind of misguide the people here. You're working in Apple or you're working in Facebook, Microsoft and Google because they have already outsourced entire operations to Accenture. Right, but Apple haven't done that. So if you're working in Apple, it's fantastic because the packages ranges from 30 to 35 lakhs for experienced people. For a fresher, it is 9 to 10 lakhs. But to be honest, the freshers hiring and all, if you see, the Big Fours hire a lot. But in industry, the logic or the concept is you work in Big Four for 1 or 2 years and then switch to industry. That's the roadmap you need to go in. Now, this kind of explains what is the logic of doing CPA, right? Now, why you want to do CPA, you really want to understand, not because that you are stuck in CA, but to be honest, actually, that are not comfortable answers to me, right? You want to do CPA, you want to work abroad is a fantastic answer because you want to get the global recognition. You want to learn the other countries' best practices, their accounting, their finance, right? Their FP&A. Or their entire business planning, the way they account their books, the way they report their cryptocurrencies, bitcoins, the data analytics coming up in the CPA curriculum. These are all exciting stuff for me. These all make me understand, okay, student is really interested in that qualification. Not that, okay, sir, after qualification, mereko job milega, after qualification, I'll go here, there. But if you're doing some qualification, you must understand the content of that qualification. To be honest, actually, how do I know that if I'm interested in CP or not? If you're really interested in accounting, audit, tax, these are your areas, data analytics, this is where you need to understand, okay, this is a right qualification for me. But if you're interested in stock market and all those sort of things, right, more to do with analytics, right, then I would say CMA is a very good qualification because CMA deals with a lot of management related stuff, right? It deals with why rather than what. But in CPA, it is more to do with audit. Yes, CPAs are more respected because auditor is always respected, to be honest. In India also, if you see, chartered accountants are actually more, they get more job roles than the cost accountants, right? So that's why it's like in US also that CPAs, because they are being appointed they are reporting to the external parties and all, right? So a lot of the investors trust on CPA signs and all. Their one signature also is so very important. Like in India, we have the chartered accountancy signature, same is with the CPA. Okay. So these are some of the points you must understand why you want to do CPA before I talk about the session. India may exam, every month exam is there, multiple choice, takes lesser period of time. But I need to understand why I want to do this course. And that is a very, very important question that actually sets up, okay, you have that potential to become a CPA or not. To become a CPA, you just need an interest, right? Are you really interested in accounting, in financial accounting reporting, in balance sheet, P&L, in analytics, in reading the annual report, knowing what is there? So these are very, very important questions you need to understand. I mean, how many of us read the newspapers also daily? I mean, if you're not reading newspapers, you're not tracking financial reports, you're not reading anything about accounting and all, please don't waste your time in this qualification and waste your money. I mean, you will just waste your money in this particular thing. These institutes will be just selling you like anything. It will just become a selling kind of thing. But if you're really interested, you're reading newspapers, you're reading Economic Times, you want to know IFRS US GAAP, how mergers are happening, how acquisitions are happening, how accounting is happening, how cryptocurrency market is coming up now, how crypto's accounting will be done today, what is the future of accounting, what is data analytics, how is technology impacting our profession? These are all certain points. If you're knowing it, if you want to really understand it, then you do this course. Just don't do exam India mein hai, it takes 7 months, 6 months, CA takes five years, 4 years. These are all stupidity. I mean, this is stupidity, to be honest, actually, because any qualification have its own importance. Even CPA also can take 5 years also, right? If you don't pay closer attention, because this exam is also not so difficult like CA, but at least it's a good exam, right? It still needs your devotion and dedication to pass this exam also, right? Okay. Okay, anyways, so let's come, once you have known it, what it is. So what is US CPA? As I said, you like in India, we have the chartered accountancy. The US chartered accountants are known as certified public accountant CPA. So you need 3 years, 1 year work experience. It can be before or it can be after. Articleship experience also can be considered at times in different state boards. As you know, in the CPA, there are a lot of state boards, right? Now, this is a very, very important point, and this is the one reason why institute plays such an important role to determine whether you are eligible or not. And that's why we have a good separate team of evaluation to know why is like that, because every state in US have its own powers, right? So the CPA exam is uniform. I mean, the CPA exam doesn't change from state to state. Or if I'm from California state, or if he's from Guam state, doesn't make that he's superior, I'm inferior, because the exam is uniform CPA examination. So it doesn't make any difference whichever state you do, but every state has its own eligibility requirement. So you need to see whether you are eligible for the CP exam or not. Sir, if I'm a BCom, am I eligible? Yes is the answer. But you will need to undertake a bridge course in order to sit. Why, sir? Because every year of your graduation gets converted into certain number of credits known as. So these credits are considered as first year graduation gives you 30 credits. Second year of your graduation gives you 30 credits. Third year of your graduation gives you 30. But US requires 16 years of education. Unfortunately, in India, we have 15 years of education. That is in the first year, second year, and then you have a BCom graduation of 3 years. So 12 plus 3 becomes 15 years, right? And that's why we tell a lot of the people who are just a BCom to go for a bridge course to sit for the CP exam. So should I wait for the bridge course to complete? No is the answer. You just register with the bridge course and sit for the CP exam. You don't need to wait for the bridge course to complete. And that is why it's a very, very important thing for a graduate who just a fresh graduate, no CA exam, nothing, no CMA, no ICWI, no company secretary. So just a pure BCom also is eligible for the CP exam, right? So bridge course is nothing, but we have signed up with few universities. So you just need to undertake that bridge course, which is just a replica of the CP exam itself. The same CPA content I have put in that bridge course. It's a distance course. You just need to, you don't even need to attend the classes. It's very, very basic course. What is covered in CPA, same is covered in that bridge course. Why are we doing that? Because we need that additional 30 credits. As you see in CPA, you have 90 credits because of your BCom, but to sit for the CPA exam, you need 120. So even if you just register for that bridge course, which gives you 30 credits, you can still sit, you can still write your exam, right? Now, if I'm a CA final, if I'm a chartered accountant, if I'm ICWI, if I'm a CS or a company secretary. So if you're an MBA, you get additional 60 credit, your BCom 90 and MBA gives you 60, 150. If you're a chartered accountant, 60 credit. If you're a CA inter, you get 30. So 90 plus 30, 120, you don't need to do a bridge course. But again, you need to see that in order to get the license, you need 150, right? So anyways, in future, you will have to do the bridge course. So you better you can do now only. Now, what is a license, sir? See, if I want to use the letter CPA, you need to be a licensed person. So what is that license means? You need to have 150 credits in order to sit for the license. And that licensing have 3 years of requirement. After you pass the exam, you have 3 years of time to get the CPA license. So you don't need to worry on anything because I myself a licensed CPA, right? So 120 is required to sit for the CPA exam. 150 is required to get the license. But after the exam, you have 3 years of time and they keep extending it to get the license of to get those 150 credits. So you don't need to worry for any of these things, right? So if you're a BCom and MCom, you straight away get 150. If you're a BCom CA, you get 150. If you're just a chartered accountant with no BCom, you can still be eligible without BCom also. And with just a chartered accountancy, you can still be eligible, but we'll need to see your documents. All right. If you're a BCom CA inter, you get 120. You still need to get additional 30 and all and bridge those requirements. Same for others. All right. If you're just a BCom MCom, 150. BCom MBA, 150. Right. So why, sir, MBA gives 60 credits, a CA gives 60 credits. So apart from your 90 BCom, you get 60 and you get 150. And that's where. But just to make it simpler for everyone, you just need to get 120 to sit for the exam. Exam to niklenge, baad mein license and all, we will see later. And that's why all our counselors and all, if you see whomever you talk to, Simandar, they tell first you sit for the exam. Because getting the exam is important. The big fours don't ask you whether you're licensed or not. Because end of the day, I want to pass the exam, get the job done, and that's all. Right? After I do that, Big Force itself will sponsor for your licensing also. You don't need to worry on any of those things. Okay. Okay. Anyways, so just remember the thumb rule, BCom 90. Right? If you're just a BCom, you're eligible. If you're BCom C inter, you're eligible. If you're BCom ICWI inter, eligible. BCom plus CS inter, eligible. Your BCom MCom, eligible. IGNO credit, yes, they consider Sahite. Right? So I'm seeing those questions and all. I think Sonam and Anuya is there. So they are keep answering that. Please ask in Q&A window, guys, rather than on Zoom chat, because a lot of the questions might be missed there. Okay, so please put it up on the Q&A window so that we can keep answering that. Don't put on the Zoom chat. Put it on the Q&A so that the questions can be saved there and we can keep answering that. Here, okay, so all states recognize the same exam. Uniform CP exam, as I said, you, if you are from Montana or if you are from California or if you are from Goa, doesn't make any sense. Okay. What makes sense is you need to pass the exam. That is the most significant thing. So three E's, one is education, one is experience, one is ethics. Ethics exam is open system. After you pass the CP exam, you have one more ethics exam, which is a very, very easy exam. It's an open book system. That's all. So you don't need to worry on that particular thing also. Again, guys, don't put on Zoom chat. Please put it up in Q&A. Anuja, Taranjeet, put it up in the Q&A window. If you see that there's a Q&A window on the Zoom, just put it up there so that we can pick up the questions. In Zoom chat, it goes very fast, so we might miss up the questions. Okay. Cool. So unique benefits, I've already said there are a lot of global recognition. US companies operating globally, US dominates. So that's why it's better than ACC, it's better than CPA Canada, it's better than every qualification CPA. After CA, if there is any qualification which can beat any other qualification is CPA, Certified Public Accountants. I mean, ACA, you not see a lot of UK companies in India. So you might not get that good job opportunities what you'll have from CPA. CPA Canada anyways is not recognized in India. So it's better to do a US CPA, get a Canadian CPA later, right? And then you have CFA, they don't take freshers. They normally take experienced guys. If you see a lot of CFAs, they all do JP Morgan, Morgan Stanley and all. They already have experience and then they go for it. Fresher CFA, I have not seen it, okay? Then what next? I mean, so these are all the qualifications. If you see that, am I on mute? Am I audible, everyone? Because Saiti is telling I'm on mute. Audible, Saiti, there's an issue from your end. Okay, so if you see that, so there's a global recognition, US companies operating globally, companies are listed on stock exchange, you have reciprocity, you can have the Canadian CPA, you can have the Australian New Zealand CPA, you can have Hong Kong CPA, you can have Scotland CPA, you can have ICAEW Institute of Chartered Accountant of England and Wales. So you have so many reciprocity. So one CPA qualification will open up 7-8 qualifications of other countries also. And that's why they say that CPA is recognized globally. And that is why it's a significant qualification if you see that, okay? And then you have the key organizations, AICPA, which is American Institute of Certified Public Accountancy, like in India, we have Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. The same way we have AICPA, which is American Institute of Certified Public Accountancy. Then we have the state boards. There are 55 state boards and every state board have their own requirements, as I've said you. So you have Alaska, you have Nashville, you have Montana, you have California, you have New York. So these are all the different state boards which you have in CPA. And then you have NASBA, which is the body which conducts the examination. You'll see your NTS, which is nothing but your hall ticket notice to schedule. And that's where you will see it in the NASBA single sign-on account where you see your scores. And if people are enrolled with us, we pray that you get above 90s in all the sections. Okay, and that's where the NASBA, which is National Association of State Board of Accountancy, which is actually the body where you get your NTS, your hall tickets, your process of evaluation, everything happens through this body. Excuse me. Okay, then you have Prometric because exams are happening in India, right? It's an online based exam. You need to go to Prometric and write the exam. Like we have CAT, GRE and GMAT. Same way you have a Prometric center. You go to the center like in Hyderabad, Bangalore, Mumbai, Delhi, you have the Prometric locations. You can go to that Prometric location, schedule your exam. It's a computerized exam. They will not provide you, they'll provide you the calculator. You don't need to carry any calcis. You just need to carry your passport, your hall ticket, right? And go there and write your exam. That is what it is, right? So it's a computerized based examination. It's a 50% multiple choice question and 50% is simulation. So I'll come on that simulation, which is a case law based questions. When I'll show you the Becker software and the Simandar CRM and all, there is no negative marking at all, anything like that. So step one is to meet the education requirement. We have a separate team which will help you around. Only thing is you'll need to get those transcripts and all from the university. You might go physically or you might get it through your agents and all, which we are tied up with. Or you might also send notarized copies depending on each and everything. We'll design the evaluation for you. Step two is to apply to take the CP examination. You submit your application, you get registered with Simandar and Becker's. We are the official partners of the Becker Professional Education. So if you check in Google, among the Becker, almost 90% of the students prepare through Becker in US, right? So that is the respect of Becker. I mean, it's a fantastic organization which has a great software. Right. The only thing is because the lectures are on all on the foreign accent and all, and that's why Samandar live classes become such an important thing, and that's where our live classes, our recorded lectures plays a very, very important role. Apart from the Becker software, it's like twin benefits you get, not only the Becker videos, the Becker lectures and all, but also the Samandar live classes, the Samandar study groups, the Q&A discussions and all, really makes a huge impact. Right. And step 5 may you submit it, you schedule your exam, you receive. Step 4 may you get your hall ticket, you schedule your exam with Prometric, and step 5 you get your license. That are all the 5 steps to become the CPA. Okay. And now some people are asking Becker versus Wiley, Samandar versus this, Samandar versus that. I don't want to compare all these things. I want you to check the free trial and see which classes are good for you, which person is good for you, who is guiding you in a right manner. Decide that and enroll. Okay. Don't talk, this is better, that is better. What is comfortable to you might not be comfortable to him. Okay. So better take trial classes, see whether they give the trial or free trial or any recordings. So you can go through it and see how they are teaching it and then decide it. Okay. Don't just go what others are talking, right? So that's what it is. So CPA exam highlights. So computer-based on-demand exam. So you have task-based simulation, which are short questions, case law-based questions. They'll give you one case and they'll ask you to how to solve it. Then you have written communication test, right? There's a written communication of 15% in BEC. So there are only 4 exams, guys, right? You have financial accounting reporting, you have auditing, you have regulation, you have BEC. So these are the 4 sections in CPA. It's 100% computer-graded examination. You need to score 75% to pass the exam. Okay. 50% is multiple choice, 50% is task-based scores. So if you see that, guys, 72 MCQs in audit, 8. Because what happens in CPA, every time people talk about Exam India, but they never tell what is the content in CPA. I mean, what are you studying in CPA? Right. So auditing and attestation, data analytics have come up from June. Really fantastic. From July 1st, auditing will have data analytics curriculum in this. Right. Then again, in BEC, you have data analytics, you have blockchain and all those sort of stuff covered now. 72 MCQs, 8 task-based simulation, which is nothing but case law-based questions. Okay. And then you have 66 MCQs, 8 task-based sims. Again, in regulation, which is nothing but US tax. So regulation deals with entire US tax. Financial accounting reporting deals with US GAAP, US accounting, journal entries, right, derivatives and all those sort of stuff. Business environment, may you deal with IT, corporate governance, financial management, NPV, IRR, right? Corporate finance. Auditing, may you deal with all the audit stuff. So much similar to what we have in Chartered Accountants, CS or ICWI. Auditing also plays the same role. But I'll just show you how actually these questions are put into live atmosphere, right? So let me know if you're able to see the screen, guys. I'm just navigating through Becker CPA and showing you how a task-based simulation looks like. Is everyone able to see the Becker product, guys? Yes. So if you see that, there are 4 sections, guys. So you have FAR, you have audit, you have regulation and BEC. One fantastic thing about Becker is every time it gets automatically updated. So you don't need to ask, am I seeing the latest portion? Am I getting the latest books? Am I seeing the latest things? Everything is latest in the software because the software gets auto updated. Because what happens in Indian accounting qualification, it's important that you study the latest stuff. And that's why it becomes very important that is it updated or not? Whatever you're studying, is it updated or is it outdated? And that's where you see the versions. A great company will always have the latest stuff with them so that people don't get confused. Are they reading the old part? Because in exam, they ask a lot of new stuff. But if you see the changes from June to July, there are hardly one chapter which has been added in data analytics in BEC and audit. Rest others, the portion have reduced instead of increased. So which is a good sign for us. There are hardly very less changes. So whenever any changes comes up in the Becker software, it is given, you will have the PDF also of all the changes and all, and you can go through, right? Here anyway, so these are the 4 sections, guys. You have financial, you have audit, you have regulation, and you have BEC. So if you see in financial, you have every chapter. Under every chapter, you have modules. Under every module, you have lecture, you have skill practice, you have MCQs and all. Again, if you see that, same. So a lot of them were asking me in the chat window, sir, how a simulation looks like. Can you see the screen, guys? This is what is known as task-based simulation. Is everyone able to see the simulation screen here? Now, what is a simulation screen? You will have an authoritative literature. Sir, this is a very, very good sign for us. So are you telling that 50% exam is open-based so I can cheat, I can open the book nicely, copy and write the answer? Yes is the answer. Because even after you become a chartered accountant or a CPA, you always read the book and tell it. Are you telling them straight away the section number, guys? It really doesn't happen, because as a professional, I need to check the book. I need to read the act. I need to understand it, the case, and then give the opinions. Okay. So, and that's why they test your skills on authoritative literature. They test whether are you a good reader of the act and all, and that's where they test you with the open book system. So when I tell 50% MCQ, 50% simulation, in those 50% simulation you have open book. Sir, MCQ ko bhi dete kya? Then what is the use of conducting the exam? In MCQ also, if you put open book, everyone will copy and write. So in MCQ you will never have open book. You'll only have open book in simulations. Right, in simulation you'll have authoritative literature, which is nothing but your open book system. You can read it and copy and write it. Sir, what happens is a lot of the people might waste time here and they might miss it out, because if you see that there is only 4-hour exam for every section. So if you keep copying like this, you might fail the exam also. So that's why it's important that you practice it, and that's the reason why software becomes an important part of Simandar's coaching. It's just not about the live classes. It's just not about the clearing the doubts, but it is important that you practice the software also. And that's why we tell you to purchase the software. And that's where you see the fees also of Simandar is on a higher side of 1,20,000, 1,10,000 because of the Becker software. It's not that we are taking that, but it is because of the Becker software, which is there. And I want each and every student to practice that, because it has authoritative literature. 50% of your content is tested on the software itself. Right? How you test it, how you solve it. So this is how your simulation comes up. So they will give you one case study using the information field, sales, cost of sales, right? Open books means a person can easily malpractice. No, he can't do it, Krishna. Please understand, there's no cheating and all. Why it's a cheating? Even in CA exam, 30% is open book system. They'll give you a book and they'll tell you to study from the book and write. It is very tough, to be honest. It's very easy to solve it without the book. But if it's with the book, you will waste a lot of time seeing the book first. What is there? You'd rather need to see how good you are when reading the Bear Act and all, right? So your reading skills are tested, and that's why this exam is so nice. Okay, because it's testing your reading abilities and all. And again, this is not a Google. Okay, you'll only have the literature limited here. It is in the Bear Act form. They will only give you the text and all. You will need to interpret it and write it. Like FASB question is there. So FASB is the standard setting body for US GAAP. So you are having a lot of presentation and all. They are asking you, where is the balance sheet? Where is current assets, current liabilities? What comes under current assets? So you can read it and answer there. But a lot of time will be taken in that particular thing. And that's why it's important to practice more. So it's not like malpractice and all those sort of things. Just an open book exam so that you practice more. Okay. Now, if you see that you have a Skill Master video explanations also. So that's how you have a timesheet here. That's why Becker software is so nice. I mean, it's the best among all of them. I mean, it has each and everything which is there to prepare for the CP exam. At least on the explanation, on the MCQs, on the SIMS, there are unlimited multiple choice question. One good thing is Becker have recently acquired Sana Labs. Right, which is a artificial intelligence personalized review session, which is AI based technology. So now people ask me, how is Becker Simandar different from other institutes, right? This is what actually separates us from everyone. To be honest, if someone asked me one point on this, I think this is a technology which was acquired for $150 million. And what happens in this technology is actually it analyzes the behavior of the student in the software. Okay, Sripal is very weak in M8, which is journal entries. M5, it gives me 3 stars. M4, it gives 3 stars. M3, it gives 3 stars. M1, it gives me again 1 star. Okay, so software is analyzing, okay, Sripal's weaker areas is adjusting journal entries and basics of financial accounting. So it will design your personalized review test based on your weaker areas. So that is like an artificial intelligence. It's like a machine learning. The machine is learning Sripal's behavior in the software, where he's doing the questions wrongly. On that basis only, it will throw the questions accordingly. Now, this is such an important feature because it actually helps you to practice on all your weaker areas. I have not seen any institute having that in India or in US other than Becker's. Okay, so you have 3 mock tests in Becker per section: financial, audit, regulation, BEC. So in FAR you have 3 mock tests, BEC you have 3. So overall 12 mock tests are there, apart from the flashcards, from the MCQs, lectures and all those sort of stuff. You have a lot of those additional stuff which is there in order to prepare you for the CP exam in a better manner. Now, how Simandar is playing a very big role here, I mean, if you see that we have live classes, we have the Telegram groups. We take all our live classes are again recorded. And again, we give the access to those recorded lectures also. And that's why whenever people ask me, sir, what is the schedule? What is it? Do we have the schedule? Our live classes are there. Like we are having from 25th, we are having our classes starting up for audit. And then we have regulation, then we have BEC, and then ISFAR. Right. So that's why we designed the curriculum in such a way that even though if you have missed any of the section, you can always go through the recorded lectures because they are all live classes recorded again and put into the Simandar CRM platform. Okay. So again, in Simandar, it's not just about providing the product. It's about providing the live classes. It's about providing the platform to clear your Q&As and all in the Telegram groups, right? Through our exclusive study groups composed of over 2000 students today, what we have, right? Through our tie-ups and all. And that's why it becomes very important that how you prepare and how you structure it. And again, if you see that you have the unlimited practice test, skill-based questions, and all those sort of things in each and everything. So now which section one should start off with? Is it FAR, is it audit, is it regulation, or is it BEC? Now one should decide that what is his stronger area, right? And he must select the section based on his stronger area. Suppose he's working in US tax, so he can start with regulation first. If he likes audit, if he's in assurance role in Big Four, he can start audit. If he's a fresher, he's just a student, he don't know which section it is. But if he's having chartered accountancy, if you have done CA Inter or CS Inter or ICWI Inter, so he can start with FAR first. If it's just a BCom and all, no other thing. So I would suggest BEC is the easier section among all. So you can start BEC or FAR. Again, I'm telling you which subject you love more, you need to start off with that first because the start itself is so difficult because if you're a working professional, you don't want to start with a subject you don't like because after a great period of time, you're starting CPA or you're starting one qualification or you have stopped CA and doing this. So you want to start with a subject which you love more so that you are more inclined towards this. And that's where you need to structure among all the four, which section you like more. Is it audit or is it US tax or is it US accounting or is it business, which is BEC? So that's where you need to find out what is your interest and accordingly discuss. If someone is asking me the best strategy, I would say, so you have a Telegram study group. So what happens is now at Simandar, we can't start all the four batches. I mean, you understand that, right? Because every batch will have its own timing. We'll have FAR, then we'll have audit, then we have regulation, then in BEC. So right now BEC is getting, and I want to start with FAR. So how do I do that? So what people do is they start with recorded classes because they are all live classes getting recorded. And then they ask questions in the Telegram groups, which works 24/7. Any doubts, we have our study groups. Please join in those study groups once you enroll with Simandar. And we keep clarifying each and every doubt in those groups. In every group, we have 7 alumni, 5 faculties. Everywhere, we keep answering each and every question. But we also want to clarify that people just don't ask doubts for doubt's sake. We want them to invest first, do their own research. If they don't understand something, then put it in that study groups. Though we have enormous study questions and all, we keep discussing day and night about the subject and it makes more interactive. Every day we share 5 MCQs also in each and every group so that you practice it. Even if you're a working professional, you can keep solving those questions as well, right? And that's why if you see FAR, audit, regulation, and BEC, these are the four subjects. So my advice would be to start off with the subject which you love the most, which you know the most. Don't start with the subject which you have no knowledge about, you do have never studied before. You don't want to start with a subject you fail first, right? So you want to start with a subject in which you are good at. And that's what it becomes a very, very important thing to prepare for the examination accordingly. Okay. And that's where if you're seeing that we have a lot of this stuff in the Becker software, in the Simandar login, the CRM, which we give you, right? So all of those things are there. So you have the Becker lectures also, you have the Simandar, you have the classes. Iske baad bhi, if you're failing, so I don't know, God only knows what should we do then. Okay. Because we have so much of resources available. We have the local training, we have the US training, we have the US subjects, we have the study materials, everything we have in order to pass. And that's why you see the success rate at Simandar is almost closer to 95% to 96% today. Okay. So if you see that the audit structure, as I've already said you, the audit study time is 100 hours, which you need to take it up. You have the ethics, you have assessing risk procedures, the same similar like what we have in Indian context. It's just that more application is there and data analytics is being added in the curriculum. Then you have FAR. In FAR also, if you see that conceptual framework, you have leases, revenue recognition, you have derivatives, state local government accounting, EPS. So again, 150 hours needs to be devoted for FAR. This is considered to be the tougher section among all the four sections. If you see the CPA pass percentage also, it's very high compared to chartered accountancy. Pass percentage is 10%. CPA pass percentage is 50%. Out of 100 people, 50 people pass. So the exam is not so tough, to be honest, guys. It's an easy exam. But again, if you're not dedicated, if you're overconfident, you can fail in this exam also. Any overconfidence will lead to troubles. Again, if you see in finance, business also, you have corporate governance, you have information technology, you have economics, financial management, operation management. Again, study time is 100 hours. Then you have regulation, which is US tax, business law, federal taxation of property, individual taxation, entities. Now, a lot of the people want to practice regulation very nicely. Why? Because if they want to open their own CPA firm in India, they want to get a lot of US tax work here. And that's why these regulation classes we teach in such a way that tomorrow, if you want to start your own something, that also you can do it through our lectures. So that's how our teaching is designed for regulation. FAR. In FAR also, we start from basics. If you see the study methodology, our classes happens only on Saturdays and Sundays. It happens only for 2.5 hours, not like 7-8 hours and all. I mean, which student can sit for 8 hours, whether it be physical or online? Online, though, it is not at all possible. Physical also, no one can sit 8 hours in a day. And I am not a teacher who can teach for 8 hours also. I think 2 hours also is more than sufficient for a student to understand, because after 2 hours also, he might not grasp that. Okay. So if you see our teaching methodology on FAR also, we teach from basics as if he's a non-accounting student. And that's how our accounting teaching is done. Same for regulation. It is start from the basics, ABCD. That's why we see, and the Becker videos are there also. If people don't, people see that Simandar have skipped something, and normally we don't do, they can always refer the Becker recorded videos also. But normally our teaching is from the basics, and it takes number of hours are more. If you see other institute, they might finish off FAR in 1 month, half month and all, but here it takes 2-2.5 months for each section. So overall 9 to 10 months our training goes up. Right? Because the reason is we want to go into detail. We want to explain in detail, because regulation is very new to CA, CS, IGWI or a BCom student of India. They have never read US taxation. So we want to spend a lot of time in explaining them. Same in accounting. A lot of the people don't even know accounting concepts. They don't know still why closing stock is credited to trading account. Right? So a lot of these basics people are not aware. And that's why it's important to teach from the scratch. And that's where we spend a lot of number of hours or more. It's on weekends. FAR sometimes we conduct on weekdays, but all other sections we conduct it on weekends only. Okay. And that's where it is very important that you refer that lectures also, because we teach it from the scratch. Okay. So normally 12 months is the deadline you need to prepare. I don't want to set up a deadline actually to tell, hey guys, hey Ketan, or hey, whatever the participants who are there, Chintan or Chandrika there. I don't want to tell, okay, let's target by December 2021, you'll pass. Because you can't set a deadline when you're studying, okay? You want to study as if you're studying and as if you want to learn. I don't want to set up a deadline, okay, 6 months mein khatam kar do, 10 months mein khatam. It doesn't happen like that. I want you to enjoy the subject more. You go to the depth of the subject, because tomorrow, if you want to open your own CPA firm, you should at least have a good mastery over the subject, right? And same in the industry also. Just not completing patafat 3-4 mahine mein khatam kar diye, right? Just in completing 3-4 months like a donkey preparing and going to the industry and not knowing again, right? It's better to prepare slowly and steadily, because exams are conducted every month. You can write quarterly one section, say January, February, March, one section, April, May, June, one section, July, August, September, one section, right? Quarterly one section and finish it off. Why do you want to close off CBA? What is a hurry? I don't understand this, because a lot of the people ask me, sir, I want to complete in 2 months, 3 months. After completing, where do you want to go? I mean, I don't understand this. You want to go into the depth of the content, you need to spend and invest time. You need to enjoy the subject. And that's where you will be respected in the industry also. I think Rahul, you have joined lately. As I said, your CPA exam in India is permanent. I think you are asking after December 2021, the exam is permanent in India. Anyways, if you see the pass rates, guys, overall pass percentage, and to pass CPA, first of all, you need 75%. You need to get it correct. 3/4 of them, you need to get it. No, negative marking. You need to get 75%. Sir, 3/4 in Indian exam, 40-50% aage to pass ho jate, but CP exam is since easier. That's why they tell higher passing. So you need to score 75%. But this is a percentile. It's like a graded based examination like CAT, GRE, GMAT is. So if it's tougher for others, it's tougher for you also. But you need to get 3/4 correct. Okay. And audit, if you see 51%, 59%, 46% for FAR, if you see among all the four, FAR is the tougher one. And I would say audit is also tougher, to be honest. It's a very tricky examination because MCQs, audit may, it becomes a very tricky exam. And BEC and regulation, as you see, the pass percentage, the pass rates are more. Okay, so this is a passing rate. I'm not talking about what is a minimum pass percentage. This is like if 100 people write, 51 people pass. But if you want to pass, if you want to pass CP exam, you need to score minimum of 75%. Okay. And there are no number of attempts. If you're second attempt, third attempt, even if you pass 10th attempt, they will get a job. So here in CPA in US, they don't see all this attempt and all this crap. Okay. Again, Simandar live classes taught by industry experienced faculty. Though people tell that I also teach well, but I think you'll need to go through recorded videos or some trial classes to see whether Sripal Jain teaches properly or not, or other faculties of Simandar also, right? Access with LMS, comprehensive study notes, study groups. So this is what you will find in Simandar. In Becker's, you have 1 million candidates prepared with Becker Institute. People ask me, what is the difference between Simandar, Becker and others? Top 100 accounting firms rely on Becker. 90% of what sells award winners are with Becker. Like almost every student who I prepared through Becker and through our live classes, almost if you're seeing the scores also of Simandar candidates, they'll be always above 90s, most of the times. Okay. Again, you have the personalized learning, skill-based videos, simulated exams, which I've already discussed, education requirements. These were the some of the sessions which our leaders came into Simandar. We had Invesco CFO coming up to Simandar. We had Infosys CFO. We had Reliance CFO coming up. We had Chaitanya. These all sessions are there on YouTube. It shows that how closer we are to the leadership of all the companies. It takes a very easy thing for us to place people, even who were not from our institute. Also, we have placed a lot of them. Now we are not doing it because due to the pandemic, we want to focus only on our students. But again, this is what are the leadership people who are connected with us, who have come to Simandar and given session with us. And we are also tied up very closely with all these people and all. So it makes things easier for us. You need to follow us on LinkedIn, Instagram, and YouTube. I think we are very active on these platforms. Please do follow Simandar Education on all these platforms. We keep sharing a lot of educated stuff on that. So I think there you will see a lot of these things coming up. Okay. Can you know, these were some of the sessions which I've done it in Wells Fargo and Reliance. I've addressed, I think, as the only speaker from the Chartered Accountant Fraternity to address 350 people in Reliance Auditorium. I mean, this is Reliance CFO, which we did it on blockchain and data analytics. So that's what. So this is about me, where I have meetings on campus in Hyderabad, in Bangalore. Then we have Synchrony Financial, which was the first company which have invented the credit cards, right? Then you have the Ernst & Young. Sorry, I think the voice is breaking. Is it clear now, guys? I think the internet was not stable. Is it clear now, everyone? Yes, okay. Cool then. So this is about our session. I'll open up to Q&As. Zaki, can you just unmute people? You can raise your hands if you want to ask your questions. Please raise your hand that I can take it up. Zaki, can you unmute each everyone so that we can take last 20 minutes?
Yeah.
Hello, sir. Shashwati this side.
Yeah, hi, Shashwati.
Yeah, hi. So, sir, my question is, say, for example, I get enrolled with Simandar and then I sit for one particular exam, one particular subject. And say, for example, I do not get over by the exam and like my result is not coming as pass. So next attempt, for the next attempt, what would be the fees for sitting for the next attempt?
Oh, okay. I'm so sorry. I have not discussed about the CPA fees, right? So as you see that, guys, the CPA examination fees is, so overall the CPA exam fees is $250 per section. So for four section, it comes to $1,000. Then you have $1,500, which is there for international testing fees. So motamoti, it will come to 2 lakh rupees. That is the fees for CPA examination, right? Including the exam fees and the international testing fees. So sir, these 2 lakhs, should I pay straight away? No. you need to pay over the period for per exam, it is 50,000 rupees. So if you fail the exam, you need to pay 50,000 again. Are you getting it? You need to pay the international testing fees also, which is $1,500 divided by 4, $375 plus 250. So per section fees will come closer to 50,000 rupees. So if you pay the exam, you need to pay the exam fees again, you need to pay the testing fees again. Only thing which you don't pay is the application fees.
Okay, sir. And sir, how long this application fees will be valid?
It will be valid, till what happens is, in the next time when you pay the application fees, you will need to pay $50 instead of $100. So actually you still need to pay, but the fees get reduced for application by 50%. But that really doesn't make difference, okay? Because anyways, you are paying 50,000 rupees for exam fees. You wanted discount on that, but they don't give it. That is a problem. So see, normally we don't talk about failing and all, but since you have asked that question, it's a very valid question because of certain difficulties and all. Rather, I would say you must postpone the attempt because we have 12 mocks in Becker. Right, in the 12 mock test, if you're not scoring above 75, you should not schedule the exam. We are very clear on that. We tell each and every student to prepare from the mocks. That mock exam is like same like how we have the AICP exam. It's similar to that. So if you're scoring above 85 or 80 in that, you can comfortably schedule the exam. You should be passing the exam for sure.
Okay, sir, I have one more question, sir. Sir, in those mock exams, what are the questions we are facing? Can we expect that we can have similar questions in the actual exam?
Like, yes, because normally though I will bless that never such questions should come directly because then it doesn't test the intelligence at all. But yes, Becker is there in the market since 70 years. So they have the question bank of last 70 years. So much of the questions can come directly from the Becker software, not from other institutes who are just there for 7 or 8 years. Like in India, we have a lot of these institutes, but Becker has been there since 70 years. So you can understand 70 years of questions are there in that software. So how powerful that software might be. Okay.
And that's where I think. Answer the for those mock tests, do I need to pay any fees to Simandhar for appearing?
That's what we discussed, right? So we give you the Becker software, which covers each and everything. And we give you the Simandhar CRM, which covers the live classes, the Q&As, the doubts, the students, faculty, the Simandhar support, the evaluation, everything is there. So you don't need to pay anything over and above that.
Okay, sir. Okay. And the demo lectures that I got to know about from the Q&A window, the demo lectures are available. If I want to have an access in that demo lectures, is it chargeable, sir? Lecture of Simandhar?
Whatever links the panelists have shared, like Anuya and Sonam, that are all available on YouTube also, our teaching videos, you can always go through there. And even our demo videos are free. You can always watch that. That should not be a problem.
Okay, sir. Okay, thank you, sir. That's all from my side. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Yes, next, Zaki. Yes, Nirali, go ahead. Zaki, can you unmute Nirali?
Hi.
I have muted Sharon. Okay. Yeah, and Simran, I guess,
Yeah, Simran, go ahead.
Yeah, so I did my graduation from IGNU and I'm same intermediate qualified. So will I get 120 credit?
So Simran, you'll need to get in touch with our evaluation team. So Sonam and Anuya is there in the meeting itself. So you can contact us on 7780273388.
Right? I tried multiple times, sir, but did not get a proper reply from your team. Like they are saying, please upload your document again and again. And it's been 5 days from where I'm telling them, please provide me the link or have I got the credit or not?
Okay. See, what happens Simran at Simandhar is you're not so desperate for the students because we want to see first their education documents carefully. Sometimes institute turn around in half an hour only, they will tell you they are eligible to enroll you, right? But in our case, we take certain period of time to understand whether you're eligible or not because our one wrong advice can make your career at stake. Okay. And that's why the people take some period of time. Sometimes we take 2-3 days. Sometimes we take 4 to 5 days also to check, to get it verified from AICPA, from NASBA, from Becker's and check whether this person is eligible or not, because you are investing 3 lakhs. It is not 3,000 rupees, right? So we want you to be a little patient enough because the education requirement are not so easy. So we want to ensure that everything is perfect. And then only we want you to enroll and register with Simandhar. That's why it takes certain period of time, but it cannot take more than 1 week. That's for sure. But if there is certain difficult evaluations, we normally do a cross-checking, take a written email from the evaluation agencies so that you are not in trouble tomorrow. Okay. So Simran, can you just put in your, I think you can just put in your number there on the Q&A window so that Sonam or Anuya can pick it up and they can straight away call you up after this session. Okay. Cool. Next.
Hi there. Sharon here.
Yeah, sir.
Yeah, perfect. So I just wanted to know what would the ideal time for preparation for, you know, a working professional be? Like, let's assume that I'm still working in the company right now and I'm trying to study for CPA. So what would the ideal, you know, time period be for me to prepare for one subject if I'm taking a subject?
I think 3 months. 3 months is what I have discussed, right? So I don't know. Which company are you working with, Sharon?
I'm working for Ernst & Young.
Okay. EY, the GDS or the EY India?
GDS. GDS, yeah.
So you will not get any time anyways to study in your busy season.
Yeah.
So it's like you'll get 1 or 2 hours per day. I think it's more than sufficient. On weekends, you can spend 3 to 4 hours. And okay, quarterly one section in busy season, I would say don't attempt anything. So taking that busy season into account, I would say 13 to 14 months you would take to complete the entire CPA qualification. Quarterly one section is what you need to plan. Like Gaurav, I think you might have seen Gaurav on LinkedIn recently. He got regulation and 95 in BC. You can get in touch with some of the people at EY, talk to some other people and discuss with them, I think, how they have structured it. But typically, normally what I recommend is every quarterly one section and go very slow and study. You don't want to have additional work pressure due to CPA also, because you are not, doing this qualification to get some another pressure, because you already have a lot of work pressure at your own market, right? So you want to go slow and study. If you take 17, 18 months also, nothing will happen. No one will come and ask you also. They're not even bothered also. So I would suggest that you go slow and study, and minimum 3 rounds of revisions are required. That's what I would say. To complete that 3 rounds of revision, at least 3 months is required for one section. If you're a working professional, if you're a full-time student and all, I think 2 months is more than sufficient and you can still go ahead. But a working professional, I would say 3 months, every day, 2 hours, consistent 2 hours, or at least 1 hour at least to start off with, so that you're in touch with the subject. Because what happens, you enroll, you get registered, tomorrow you don't write the exam. So that is very disappointing for us, right? We want you to write the exam, and that's why we are conducting MCQs in the groups. We are ensuring that everything is done to motivate you. And that's what the only 1 hour I think one can take out from his busy schedule, irrespective of how much ever busy he is, right?
Perfect, perfect. Makes sense, makes sense. Just one last add-on to the question. Let's assume that if I'm done with busy season and I'm at a period where, you know, I could invest a little more time in studying. So would it be ideal if I have maybe like 4 or 5 months in my hand to take 2 subjects up?
Yes, you can very well do that. If the busy season is done, because I know the tax season ends, you'll have little more time to invest. I think that's a good period of time to write 2 sections also. Like you can go with taxation because that's the area which you're working with. Along with regulation, you can start with BEC because BEC is the easier section. It has a highest pass percentage, and that is where the reg and BEC combination would be a good one.
All right. Perfect. Yeah, I think that's all for my session. Thank you. Yeah.
Yes. Next. Nirali, please go ahead. Zaki, can you just unmute?
Sahil? Just Sanket?
Yeah, hi, Sripal sir. This is Sanket here. I have a question that I have 5 years of work experience in non-US or Canada individual tax at a Big Four. So is it fruitful for me to pursue US CPA? If yes, in which area should I concentrate for my career growth?
So Sanket, which company are you working with? I just...
I am working with Deloitte right now.
So Deloitte, the Canadian taxation, is it?
No, not US or Canada, Australian taxation.
Okay. So I think you're talking about Deloitte Hyderabad, right? If I'm not
correct. Yes, yes.
Okay. I've seen a lot of these students registered through them and they pass CPA. They switched on to EY. See, I'm not here to kind of making a switch to other Big Fours and all, but this is my just opinion that once they pass CPA, they get promotion, they go to the manager level and all, and even at partners or director level. So now after passing CPA, what is the highest hierarchy? You become a partner of that particular company. Right, or that Big Four, or if you're in industry, you can grow at vice president or CFO level. Again, that requires good skills, good interpersonal skills, great interaction, the way you convince the people. So a lot of the other stuff is also there. It's not just about qualification. If I'm telling you that, that's very wrong from my level of counseling, right, Sanket? But yes, if you have I have not seen any BCom or any unqualified people going to a higher level in corporates. You need a professional qualification in order to grow, and that's why CPA becomes a significant aspect now. Okay, because I don't think so you can do CA when you're working, because it's already very tough exam and it takes a lot of time. So I think CPA is a very good option because you're already working in Big Fours. You have an internal job posting after 18 months. IJP is there. You can always switch the roles. You can move to US tax or US audit. And then you can, even if you want to move abroad, I think through Deloitte or through other Big Fours, you can definitely take a call, Sanket. So I think fair enough, you can go for CPA. That should not be a problem.
Thank you, Shripal sir. Yep.
Next, guys, you need to be a little quick because a lot of them have raised hands so that we can cover each and every one.
Shrikant?
Yes, Shrikant, go ahead.
Hi, Shripal. Thank you for the presentation. I have three quick questions. The first thing is, can we get access to the contents or the index of each paper? So just to get an idea.
So you have a blueprint in the AICPA website. So if you refer to that blueprint, you will get all the content. Okay, so you can always check that blueprint and get the access to the content. That should not be a problem. So through that blueprint only, the Becker or the other review providers prepare their books also on that basis. Because AICPA doesn't have a study material. Like you have in India, material, right? But here in USCPA, what happens? The review providers prepare the material based on the blueprint which is given. So AICPA only share the index and the content. They don't provide the material. So the review providers prepare the material basis on that blueprint. That blueprint is available on AICPA. You can always check on Google also. AICPA blueprint, if you type, you will get it.
Okay, sure. The second question is, how long are Simandar videos per subject? I mean, just to get an idea, how many hours I need to invest for per paper?
So typically, FAR is the maximum number of hours. So we have 200 hours in FAR. Audit, Reg and BC, it is 80-90 hours. So it's closer to 100 hours. So overall, if you see that, 500 to 600 hours, you're closer to 500 hours you're devoting on all the four sections. But again, you can always increase the speed where you think you're very confident on, you don't require. That's the beauty about the recordings. And you can attend the live classes wherever you want. So we are giving both the accesses because we want to be a little flexible, because you see a lot of working professionals are also doing that. You don't want to discipline them that you need to attend live classes and all. Then it will become a real torture for them. Already having their own deadlines and deliverables, they can't really attend the live. A lot of them also ask me, sir, either branch, other branch. But to be honest, in the physical classes, many of them don't come regularly also. That's why we tend to have these recorded classes along with live classes. So if they miss any of the thing, they can always watch the recording. They want to clarify doubts, they can put it in the study group. That methodology is a big hit. And that's a good way of approaching it also. And it saves a lot of travel time.
Yes.
You don't need to go anywhere and all. You can sit at home and study. And that's what I think is very important. Yes,
absolutely. I mean, we can study at our interest and our time and our pace. So I completely agree with that. The third last question I had is, we had an 18-month timeline to complete all the four papers, right? This timeline starts from the day you pass the exam or the day you get the result of your first paper?
The day you get the result of the first paper, from there you will have 18 months of time to finish the other three papers. That is
even if you fail... Then the time starts.
I mean, there's no point, right? Once you pass from that passing time, you'll have. So every score is valid for 18 months. That's the thumb rule. But the another thumb rule is, the moment you get that score result, the other three section needs to be passed within 18 months. So that's the catch. So to be honest, actually, once you get the result from that day, suppose for an example, I've written the FAR exam in the month of January. February 15th, I've got the result of FAR. From February 15th, you'll have 18 months of time to write other three sections and pass it. Suppose if you don't pass the other three sections, the FAR result which you have passed will get lapsed. Are you getting it?
So the 15th Feb result, if in case it's a pass, then 18 months timeline starts on 15th Feb.
Yes.
If in case it's a fail, it will not start. Got it.
It will definitely not start.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Shripal. Yeah.
Yes, next.
Sai
Kirtana.
Okay, others.
Just keep on unmuting, Zaki. Can we be a little quick? Because a lot of them have raised hands and they are waiting actually. Yes, Sai Kirtana.
Sir, thank you, sir, for giving me chance.
Yeah.
Sir, am I audible to you?
Yes. Yes, Kirtana.
Sir, 3 days back, I took FAR classes.
Mm-hmm.
So, Sonam ma'am already told me that there are certain amendments in FAR. So I intentionally took the FAR because I'm interested in FAR subject because I'm a IPCC completed.
Okay.
So my question is, when will I get new books and is my decision is correct?
No, 110% it is correct, because in the FAR, there are no amendments. The portion have been reduced. It have not increased. When it is increased, then it makes sense. But the portion have reduced. So it's good that you have a reduced content and all. So whenever new books, you can always order. You can get in touch with Sonam and get that thing done. That should not be a problem at all. You have started with FAR because you can't wait, right? Because the updates are coming up in the June 1st week. So books normally will come, say, mostly by June 2nd week. So normally what we do is we don't tell students to wait and all, because already all the PDFs, the amendments are all covered in the Becker software itself. So you can always download the PDF from there. That should not be a problem, because every three months new update comes. So we can't keep giving books every two to three months, right? Like that, four times I need to give books. So that's where the amendments are updated. All the PDFs are kept on the Becker software itself. Like when I've started the session, I showed to the students that any new updates, any new amendments comes up, the software gets automatically updated. And you'll find the PDF, the soft copy of that in the software itself. You can download that and take out the printout. It will be hardly 15-20 pages, which you need to study. If there's a significant changes and all, normally we tell the student to purchase the book. Else, no, because the current books will be more than sufficient, to be honest. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Next.
Hi, sir. My question is regarding the eligibility. So right now I'm a BCom honors graduate and a working professional. So it gives me 90 credits. But I've heard that if you are passed out from an NAC accredited university, then you can appear for the exams. But for license, I'll have to get 60 more credits. So what is your advice regarding the bridge course? Like, should I enroll it after passing my CPA exams, or should it go along with the CPA preparation?
My suggestion would be to straight away register for the bridge course. Don't wait for the CPA exam to complete, because that bridge course is just a replica of CPA exam itself. So you don't need to study anything. Neither they conduct the classes. It's like all recorded. It's very easy exam. Okay. So it's not like MCOM and all. So I would suggest that you register for that. I mean, what is waiting for you? But if it's financial issues and all, then I would suggest that after you write the exam also, you can register. So there's no hard and fast rule like that. Okay. So right now you can appear for the exam and go ahead and all. Okay. But why we tell bridge course and all is because you'll save a lot of time, right? So anyhow, you are preparing for the CPA exam. So parallel, you can prepare for the bridge course also, because there is nothing duplication what you see. So you're not studying anything additional, I would say. It's the same thing what is covered that will be asked there also, the same only. Okay. Does it solve, Simran? Are you?
Yes, sir. Thank you so much.
Yeah. So there is no hard and fast rule. I mean, you can register, or you can register after the exams also. So there's nothing like that, that you need to register it immediately. Just a second. Okay. Yes, next, Balaji.
Hello. Hi, sir. I have a query. Like, I have 6 years of experience in Indian corporate act, and I've cleared my CA final group one, and I wish to, you know, get into US tax, non-US tax as well. So, like, you know, if I pursue CPA and, you know, complete CPA, I'll be considered as a fresher, you know, for US taxation profile, or whether I'd be like 6 years of experience in Indian corporate tax would be considered.
Like, even currently which company you're working with, Balaji?
Yeah, currently it's a real estate company based in Mumbai. Real estate.
So they will be considering that as a fresher, Balaji. So because you don't have any experience in US tax, right? So they will consider you as a fresher, and they will pay you like a fresher only. Like 7.5 to 8 lakhs is a starting package of a CPA, right? Okay. So that would be package for you once you pass the exam.
So, sir, current my salary is 9 lakhs, even if I complete CPA, then I'll have to downgrade myself, like, from a salary perspective, if I go for US taxation.
Yes, if you're going into the relevant field like finance or audit and all, then the compensation will not be reduced. But if you're going definitely to a different field in which you don't have any experience, then you'll be considered as a fresher only. And the compensation, you will have to compromise if it's a big four, right? So that's what, see, I want to give you honest opinion. Just don't want to tell you are a CPA karla and your package will increase. That's not me. That's not the way we guide, right? Because you're going into a different field. Definitely, you will be considered as a fresher and you'll have to take a hit on your compensation. But that is fair enough, because you want to do something which you really like. right? And when you like something, you'll have to sacrifice something also to that extent. And that's where I think you'll have to take a tough decision. But the growth is enormous. If you see the long-term picture in that particular zone where you like something and you're going into that zone, the growth is actually, I would say, compounding triple. It's not double, okay? And that is the beauty of doing something which you really like. So I would go ahead with your decision and tell, hey, please go ahead, okay? And that's what I would suggest you also.
Like one question, like, you know, since my current experience is Indian.
Hello.
Yeah. Okay, thank you, Balaji. I think that kind of clarifies. You can consider as a question. We can mute all of them. Thanks. Yeah, Balaji, you were telling something?
Like, sir, like I was telling, you know, like you. Since my current experience is Indian corporate taxation impact, so like if I pursue CPA, complete CPA, and then if I go something other than US taxation, then you are saying it will add value to my current profile?
Please understand, you are in Indian corporate taxation. So from India tax, you're going to US GAAP or US accounting, US audit or US tax, you'll be considered as a fresher only. That's what I'm telling, because see, you think from the recruiter aspect, right? Why will a recruiter hire a person who has no experience in that particular field? So he'll be treating him as a fresher itself. I mean, see, it's an honest answer, not, I mean, I can just tell you that, hey, you will be taken up at that package. To be honest with you, I mean, if I'm a recruiter, I'll definitely not take a person at a higher package because you are a fresher for me. I mean, your Indian corporate taxation has no relevance in Accenture or Capgemini. Yes, in international taxation to certain extent, like transfer pricing and all, but in other profiles, I mean, it doesn't make any sense. Okay, so it will be treated as if, yeah, for that experience, they might pay you a lakh additional. That's all I would say, because you have gathered that communication skills, you know how to talk to clients, but to that extent, they might compensate you for that experience. That's all. Okay.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
Yeah, my pleasure, Balaji. Yes, next. Zaki, yeah. Can we be a little quick, because a lot of them are putting in the chat window, they want to ask. Yes.
Hello, sir. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, good evening. So I just have a couple of questions. The first one is, since the exam is, I think I'm...
Zaki, can you just unmute? Can you just mute others?
Yeah, sir. Yeah, since the exam is happening in India, do we still need passport for writing the exam or applying for NTAs and all that? I mean, is passport mandatory?
Yes, passport is mandatory. Yes, it's a mandatory thing.
Okay, so for writing the exam or like before the exam, should I apply for it? I don't have it currently.
Yeah, so you will not write the exam immediately, right? You will take 3 to 4 months of time to prepare and write the exam. So you can apply for the passport now. You'll get it after 3, 4 months or 5 months, also it doesn't make difference, right? You don't need to wait for the passport to come to start the preparation. You can straight away start your preparation. That should not be a problem.
Yes, yes, right. And one more question is that I'm currently working in Deloitte USA right now. So I didn't apply for my evaluation, but we need to be proactive in applying for the exam leave. So if I start evaluation process just now, so when do you think I can schedule my exam, sir?
So you should be able to write the exam by August mid. So if you start, say, by May, so anyways, you will take, see, the problem with a lot of the students, what happens is they are so focused on evaluation. What we want to understand is that you will also take your time, right? You can't write the exam in 1 month. You need to prepare. So 3.5-4 months, it will anyways take to write for the first exam. Parallelly, your evaluation also will complete. So you don't need to wait for your evaluation report to come and then start the preparation.
But I have to apply for the exam.
Simultaneously, the process can be started and you can look to actually write your first exam in mid-August. That would be your timeline. And you can write two also. You can prepare two subjects parallelly and you can write, because I know the busy season is over for Deloitte now.
Yes.
So you'll have a lot of time before the interim busy season starts in September, right? So by that time you can attend BEC and audit, because you're already in assurance. So audit and BEC is a good combination, one easier and one tougher. So that's the way you'll need to take it up.
Yeah. So do you think, what about FAR, sir? So can I start FAR?
Yeah, FAR also. I'm so sorry, actually. FAR is a good combination, to be honest. FAR and audit is a good combination instead of BEC and audit, because you'll not get free time again.
Yes.
Right? So you want to start with a tough, a bigger subject like FAR. So I think you can do that. FAR and audit is a good combo. And evaluation, you can get in touch with the team. You can straight away start it immediately. We do have every month twice the evaluation session. Sonam is also there. So you can check with the relevant point of contacts in Deloitte. I think the Deloitte leadership team will guide you to our team. So that should not be a problem.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yep. Yes, next. Zaki.
Hello.
Yes, Ketan, go ahead.
I have a question. I have applied for the transcript of CA, but for applying the transcript of university, I have a problem because it is a lockdown. And can I apply for the transcript after completing the exam, means passing the...
No, it doesn't happen, Ketan. So what happens is, right now it's a lockdown, I understand.
Yeah.
So you cannot have a lockdown for 10 years, right? So you can have for half month or 1 month, we can understand. Next month, country also needs to grow. They also need to earn revenue. Universities also want to earn revenue. Everyone wants to earn. So it's just the time phase of 15 to 20 days. Next month onwards, you'll get your transcripts on time. So that should not be a problem. You can choose your transcript, but parallelly, I would suggest you to you keep preparing. If it gets late, you prepare for 2 exams. That's what I would say, that you don't wait for the transcripts and all. You parallelly prepare. And we also have certain agencies. Get in touch with our people. So they will send their agents and they will collect on your behalf. We charge you for that, which is fair enough. At least you're getting your transcripts, but you don't need to visit. They will visit on your behalf and they'll get. So they rather outsource your entire stuff. You can outsource to them. And they will collect on your behalf.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes, next.
Hari.
Hello.
Yes, Hari, go ahead.
Hello.
Yes, Hari, you're audible. Please go ahead.
Hello.
Yes, Hari, we can hear you.
Hello. Hi, Sripad.
Yeah, Hari, go ahead.
I'm audible to you?
Yes, yes, yes.
Hello.
Yes, Hari, you're audible. Please go ahead.
Hello.
I think he's having some problems.
Yeah. I'm audible to you, Sipa?
Yes, Hari, we can hear him actually.
Hello.
I think Zaki, can you just mute him?
Okay.
And we can
actually, I have completed my graduation in 2017, Sipa.
Okay, yeah.
Hello.
Yes, yes, Hari, go ahead, please.
Okay, actually, I have completed my graduation in 2016 and got placement in Wipro SAP technology.
Okay.
And after that, after completion of 4 years in Wipro, I have recently joined to Cognizant as well, okay? And I'm working for SAP technology for Romania location, Levis plant. This SAP experience will be considered for CPA, SIPA?
Yes, yes, yes. For licensing, it will be considered. That 1 year work experience, SAP is definitely considered. I will attest that should not be a problem.
Means,
and even after you pass the exam also, I think SAP is a terrific skill set to have. And we are seeing a lot of the consulting roles opening up in HCL. We have placed few people there. So I think that's a...
Actually, I have worked as a consultant, tester and individual. 3 roles I have worked for SAP.
Good that you have a technical skill, right? I think it should be a good value add, Hari, because see, you have the functional role, you have the technical role also, right? So that's a good win. So it's like a techno-functional role which you can target after you pass CPA.
And one thing is like, if this S4HANA also will be helpful for CPA or SAP is fine, Sripal?
Yes, it can. See, because at least the systems knowledge you have, right? So you can
you
start with BEC section, to be honest, because it has a lot of IT element in it. So anyways, you have a good system knowledge. That's a very, very good skill you have.
I'm having around 5 years of experience in MNCs.
It's a value add only. After CPA, I think it will definitely add value.
Now I'm having having good package only. If I complete, I'll be getting a good package. I'll be treated as fresher and I'll be getting less Sripa.
No. It will be considered as equivalent only because you are having a relevant experience. If you go tomorrow to Infosys or other IT companies, it's a good experience to have on. Okay. And you have a tech skill. They normally pay good. Okay. Thank you.
This SAP and S4HANA both will work as an experience and it will be adding to CPA, right?
Yes, yes. S4HANA, we need to see because SAP FICO is good.
I'm working at SAP FI, not controlling also. I'm having skills.
FI is very good, right? FI is also good, but HANA and all that's not related to more core finance.
HANA, I'm not started. Means I'm thinking to start in future. Means after 3-4 months, but I'm thinking to start CPA before that.
Correct. No. You can go ahead with that. That should not be a problem.
And one more thing, with this 5 years experience plus CPA, it will be possible to get abroad chances.
Again, I said you that you will need a visa and all other factors play a role. So I can't send you abroad, to be honest. You'll need to actually write IELTS exam or TOEFL exam and get it into that. Or your company should sponsor for your visa. Yes, with CPA, it opens up the chances, but you'll have to take your own effort. Okay. Yep. Thank you. Okay. Yes, thank next. You. Guys, we'll have to be very quick because a lot of the people are complaining that there's a lot of...
Hi, Pavan this side.
Pavan. Yes.
See, my background is I'm M.Tech in data science with the previous 15 years experience and presently working as data scientist in an NBFC named Edelweiss at Mumbai corporate office. So, see, I want to do CPA and I already enrolled with you and I started with my FAR preparation. My point is which area or which are the use cases industry is looking and in which companies I can be placed by application of data science into audit, taxation, accounting, and fraud analytics. Even I'm doing FRM also.
So Pavan, Big Four's consulting role is the ideal combination because they are the one who are working on data analytics and all this skill set. Yep. And most of the time, the data analytics is being used on the audit tool also now. Yeah. With the BI tool also coming up, Power BI there. Yeah. Data analytics, the auditing is going into a complete transformation. That's what you will be seeing in the auditing section also now. So that will open up your role in that particular dimension. Okay. And then second thing is the leases and the revenue recognition concepts and all. The industry is working closely on those two standards apart from the derivatives, the financial instruments.
Yeah.
So this is what we are having the latest update. FASB is currently working on these three important standards. Apart from that, insurance standard also is coming up. It was deferred this year.
Yes.
Yeah. Might closely come next year to, I think, 2022 end. And that could also be an ideal standard to work on that particular.
So anything your strategy to place in this kind of mixed combination of analytics and these use cases into standards?
Yes, we can do it because you have a relevant qualification also like M.Tech, right?
Yeah.
So they would definitely take you up. Again, it will be little compensation terms. You need to take a little.
That's okay. I'm looking for bigger picture. So not an issue for me. So any, I would like to be connect with you for this kind of strategy that where I can be placed in a good position sometime.
Sure. So we have a mentoring one-to-one session, which I take once a student enrolls with Simandar. So you can fill that mentoring form. Sonam or Anuya can send you that form or the student relationship team. Great. And we can have a mentoring call. So I do that with every candidate of Simandar. So you can fill that mentoring form and I can discuss your study plan and other strategies there.
Great. Thanks. Thanks for this. Thanks a lot.
Yes. Next. Zaki, can we be a little faster because...
Yeah.
Hello? Sir, Nidish... Hello?
Yes, please.
Sir, Nidish here. I just wanted to ask that does Simandar allow students to enroll with Simandar only for some of the individual subjects? Like if I am doing the course by myself...
Unfortunately, what happens is if there is an individual section, right, the pricing goes up substantially because Becker doesn't allow individual section selling. And that's why we tell that it's better to enroll for 4. If you go for 2, it will be almost 80% of the cost. And that is one of the reason we don't encourage because we are following the Becker policies. That's the only thing, Nidish. Okay.
So one more thing. Is it preferable to apply through NIES or WES?
This will depend on your evaluation and education documents. You can send the documents to the team and they can guide you better on that. Okay. So once you send it, they will give you an opinion on which evaluation agency once you enroll with, and they'll take a return confirmation. And then with that evaluation agency only, you will be sent across. So this will be all documented so that you can tomorrow criticize Simandar also for doing wrong evaluation. Okay?
No, that's not an issue.
It's always there and documented. Okay. Don't worry on that particular front.
So will I have to enroll for this?
We'll give you the best states, best evaluation agency. Once you send the documents, we'll take the entire accountability. You don't need to worry on that particular aspect at all.
Okay, so to your send the documents, I'll help you enroll?
Yes.
First?
Yes, Nidish.
Okay, thank you so much. Thank you.
Yes, next.
Hello.
Yes, who's this?
Hi, Shripa sir. This is Isha here.
Yeah, Isha, go ahead.
Yeah, sir, I have connected with you on LinkedIn and I spoke to you a couple of times, and I would like to just, you know, brief you about my profile, because in the start of the presentation you just mentioned that you that there's an option of going to CMA also, but I want you to know that, you know, I completed my BAF as well as my MCOM, and I did my BAF in the year 2017. Post that, I was working with BNP Paribas as a fund accountant, where I was mainly dealing with the derivatives and equities sides. So, but you know, working, I mean, studying in the BAF section as well as the MCOM, I have got a gist about the account subjects also. So I have an inclination towards CPA, and apart from that,
Isha, what I would suggest is start off with CPA. See, because it is very easy to switch from accounting to analyst, but from analyst to accounting is not easy. I mean, from a CFA, if you're going to CPA, is not easy. From CPA to CFA is very easy, because to analyze something, you need to have a great accounting knowledge also. So if I want to understand a financial statement, I need to know how it is accounted first, how it is disclosed first, how it is presented first. That's why I would suggest to start off with a CPA qualification. You already have your derivatives and all those knowledge with you. Yes. All those technical knowledge can be very handy when you are accounting for that, because you can account only when you have a good knowledge about the concepts also, right? So it's a good profile to be in with. I mean, it's a terrific thing to start off with. I think BNB also sponsors for CPA, if I'm not wrong. So you can get in touch, and we can do one session there also. I'm not sure if you are tied up with BNB. I can check with our team. But definitely, I think they can reimburse also. You can talk to your company.
No, sir. Actually, I already discontinued working with BNP. And since I got a better opportunity, I'm working with Enfusion. It is a US-based company.
So just check with your company, if they sponsor and all. Or if they don't also... push them, ki yaar, this is a good initiative, sponsor for this, this will be a learning thing and all. Get that things going. But I think the qualification wise, it is indispensable that you have that, because tomorrow if you want to go to a higher level, I don't think so, you can go only with BAF and all these things. Okay.
Yeah, correct, sir. I need a professional qualification, as you said.
I think any given
day. So you think, right, that I should go ahead with CPA and not CMA?
Yes, yeah. Other exams anyways are not happening. CPA is a shorter qualification. CA exams are not happening this year. Mostly till July, August, it won't happen, because the way the pandemic is going on. CFA exams have been cancelled. So you have a good option of CPA at least to complete. Why do you waste time? Okay. So that's where I think it's a good thing. Okay.
But my current designation and my roles will be considered once I become a CPA.
Yes. That's a relevant experience.
Of my four exams will be passed.
RCSM. I can place you in DSHO, RCSM, State Street. These are good companies to place you in. So that should not be a problem.
But sir, if I want to go into the big fours then?
Yes, it will be considered, but they'll not give more compensation for it, because that doesn't make any sense for them. Okay, because big fours are not into the analyst part. I mean, they have a different profile altogether. They need good amount of experience. They have advisory role, which is fast. And they have valuation profile also, but that is very cream. Okay. It's not easy to get into those profiles straight away. They have their openings very limited way. So I don't want to misguide you on that, because the opportunities are very limited in big fours. And also people don't leave that role. Once they are passing CPA, they go into valuation profile. They don't leave the company so fast. So the hiring is not so rapid like we have in audit and all other things. But fair enough, they'll consider that on the package front. You can expect 9 lakhs closer if you have 1 to 2 years of experience in big fours. Okay.
But it is not quite, it is not extremely impossible to get into big fours, right?
No. It's everything is possible. So we have connects. You don't need to worry. You just need to show your interest. Everything is possible. Okay.
Yeah, sir,
if there's no interest, nothing will be possible. That is how it is. Okay.
Thank you, sir. I'm done.
Thank you. Yes, next.
Bindu.
I think, can you unmute Divya? Yes, Bindu.
Shripal, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, hi, Shripal. This is Bindu. I have qualified CA in the year 2004, Shripal. So I have 2.5 years experience with Deloitte as an audit manager. Then I moved to Genpact in 2010. So from then I'm working with Genpact in FP&A role, and I'm a team lead now with 15 plus members team. So doing a CPA at this point of time and moving ahead with the career, in order to move ahead with the careers, will it help me?
110% yes, because I've seen, like, you might have seen Akshay's post on LinkedIn. So he was a chartered accountant, he passed, and we shifted him to Amazon. What does this, a new qualification kind of opens up your opportunities in other companies? People think that she's studying. It actually picks up your resume and all. They think that you are a versatile professional who is actually updating herself on a consistent basis. It increases your confidence and the discipline and all. Everything changes with a qualification. It's just not about getting a good job or getting a thing, but the entire life changes when you have a good qualification to go ahead. You might have noticed that when you were doing chartered accountancy. I mean, I transformed a lot when I was doing CA. I'm really proud that I've did my chartered accountancy. I think you will see the similar experiences when you'll do CP also. I mean, it's about a satisfaction. It's about a joy. And not only that, anyways, getting a job and all with CA only, it's sufficient, but it's just that with CPA, the resume picking happens very faster and recruiters get really impressed. And with Genpact coming to a good company like Amazon or other companies, because Amazon hires a lot for FP&A, you see Microsoft doing the same. Even PepsiCo now in Hyderabad, they have expanded. So this qualification, US companies, they'll prefer a CA plus CPA. It will be a real handy for you. Okay.
Okay. And Shripal, will you be able to assist me on placing, right? Once I finish the course?
Yeah, but no guarantee. Okay.
Yeah.
I don't want to misguide on this. Whatever opportunities I have, I'm always open to share and all. But not unlike other institute, I don't want to misguide you that we place 100% and all. It really don't happen, okay? Because it happens on the opportunities, happens on the skill sets and all, and whether that company actually hires that or not. So
okay.
Time to time, I keep sharing that in Invesco, Amazon, AIG and all, Accenture, we have placed. So it keeps coming up. We keep doing that on a consistent basis. We keep helping. The support is there, but we don't give any guarantee for anything. Okay.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you, Shripal. Thank you.
Yes, next.
Chandrika.
Guys, you need to be a little quick.
Yeah, I have unmuted.
Divyanshi, can you just unmute Divyanshi because...
okay. Yes, Chandrika.
Good evening, sir.
Yeah, Chandrika, go ahead, please.
Good evening, sir. This is Chandrika. Sir, here I'm currently studying class 12th. And till now, I have seen that all the people who have earlier joined the organization or they are deciding to leave the organization. But I am currently studying in class 12th and I have going through this course. So I am deciding right now that is it CPA that is good for me? Like, I don't know either. I have
been. Yeah, that's a fantastic. So I'm so proud, Chandrika, that these questions are coming up early in your age. Great to have you here. I mean, I know other participants are waiting for their turn. I mean, hats off to your level of research which you are doing, because people here after BCom, after getting a job, they are now researching which qualification is better. So you have already done your half job there itself, that you're trying to plan for your thing. So Chandrika, I would say that since you're an intermediate, you start with chartered accountancy qualification, because CPT and all, everything you write parallelly, the moment you complete your BCom, or if you are starting your BCom, you can do USCMA along with CA or other qualification like that. But your starting point should be chartered accountancy at this level, because CPA you are not eligible, unfortunately, till you don't complete your graduation. So CA is a very good bet for you. You can start off with CA if your interest is audit, tax and all. If your interest is not that, then you stick to your intermediate only and do some course like I would say from BCom first year, a USCMA would add more value if you're going more into the analytics and all those sort of things. Okay. CPA right now, you can't do it because graduation is mandatory for CPA. Okay.
Yes, sir. Sir, but I'm here only because I knew that CA is more harder than CPA. So that's why I choose CPA except of CA, because it was known to me that it was easier. So that's why I'm here. So without CA, can I do CPA with more procedure if I have the consequences to
do? Yes, after BCom, you can do that. But before BCom, what will you do? You have 3 years time, right? So you can always do CA or USCMA. Why do you want to waste time? No, see me, I've done CA and CPA together. So you can definitely do both the qualifications also. But again, if you don't want that to happen and all, you can go BCom, enjoy and all, and study CPA after BCom also. That should not be a problem. Okay.
Yes, sir. But can I do CPA preparation along with the BCom?
Yes, you can do that. Definitely you can do that. But the problem is after 3 years, a portion will get changed. So I don't want to enroll you on wrong things, okay? Because other institute, they might do that and they might enroll you. But what is the use? Because after 3 years, this is not like Indian content. It keeps getting dynamically changed. Again, in 6 months, it will get changed. So if you enroll now, it doesn't make any difference. And it will not add any value to you. That's why I was telling a powerful qualification like chartered accountancy at your age will actually make you more disciplined and all. So that's a good thing to have for it. If you are not looking or not doing anything, even a CA inter also, you can do it and wait and complete CPA and then do CA later also. So that's what I would suggest. But CPA right now, starting from BCom first year, doesn't make any sense.
Okay, sir. So what's the conclusion is that I have to do BCom and I have to choose an appropriate course so that I can apply for CPA. Sir, am I audible to you?
Yes,
sir. My answer?
Yeah, Chandrika. So that's what we discussed, right? So I think I'm having some connectivity. Guys, are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir. Now you are audible.
Yes. So that's what, Chandrika, I think you can go ahead with that. And I think a BCom, so what I've discussed is, along with BCom, you just stick to whatever it is, like a CA or something like that. And after you complete your graduation, you can always go ahead for a CPA. Okay. Thank you so much, guys, for attending this. I'm sure you would have loved this session. Please do have the recording enabled in the YouTube and you can go ahead. Thank you so much, guys. Thanks a lot.